some of the tunes I didn't know, and I was like, oh wow, that's a cool tune. So we're going to start with a song that I haven't played, never played before, but I heard, and it's a cool tune, I think so. Hopefully you do too at the end. And this is called I'll Be Seeing You. Listen to Jordy Stitt on the piano. Nick Quigley on the bass. Sammy C. Sam Castan on the drums. Wow. This one's called Where Are You? And this is there's a really cool version by Kenny Dorham on an album that he that he sings on, which is called Kenny Dorham Sings and Plays. Creative. But it's also, it's interesting because when I look through the history of, you know, when things are recorded and all that sort of stuff, this is recorded around 1963 by Kenny Dorham. And then I checked out, and it's interesting that Sonny Rollins recorded this around the same time, and Dexter Gordon did too. And interestingly enough, both the Sonny Rollins and Dexter Gordon versions are a little bit more similar, and the Kenny Dorham one was different. So I find that fascinating, like that what was interesting when I was travelling around is that different tunes get played in different cities, and there was no sort of common theme between the cities as to what tunes were being played by the locals. So I think the same thing's happened in recorded history of jazz, is that around the same time, people are playing the same tunes, and then 10 years later, they're playing different tunes. So here we go. This is Where Are You? Thank you. this version is probably a bit more, is taken more from the Lee Morgan version that he recorded on an album called something, I can't remember. But if you look up, you go to my head, this is the name of the tune, you go to my head by Lee Morgan, you'll get it. Here we go. Thank you. thinking about this recently, especially like at this point in time with JMI with student recitals. So it's really really cool to see and hear the students where they're at and what they've been practicing on what. So I'm not going to divulge any, but I will say that it's very encouraging because all the students I've seen so far, I know more and are playing better than what I was when I was in my first, second, and third year at uni. So that's cool. So yeah, give them a round of applause for that.
Yeah.
But then that made me reflect on when I was at uni, and that was a long time ago. And it's interesting because I did my first professional gigs when I was 17. And before that, I was actually doing gigs in my dad and Greg's band. I was probably about 14 or 15 doing gigs. But I don't consider them professional because I wasn't getting paid. I wasn't paying rent either, so it's all good. But I did my, I do remember doing my first professional gigs at the age of 17, and on my 18th birthday, I was doing a gig, which is, I actually enjoyed it, because, you know, that was fun. But that made me realise that was 30 years ago. So, it's a long time, but it sort of makes me realise I actually still feel like I'm just scraping the surface. So to my students, keep at it, please. So this next tune is a lovely ballad called Embraceable You.
Oh.
Thank you.
recent trip to the UK and Europe. It's the first time I've been. So I couldn't encourage all of you. If you haven't been before, save your money, go. It's awesome. But there's a lot of flight time involved. And there's the layover in Doha Airport where you can pay $17 for a can of Coke. Deal. Yeah, there's nothing else to do in Doha, so they can guess they can charge it. But end up reading three books over the time. So that was good. But it was interesting because the whole language thing, you know. So that was good. Anyway, we finished up our trip in Paris. So that was a surprise. If anyone tries to tell you that the French are arrogant, don't believe them. They were the nicest, loveliest people. Even though I can't speak French. So there you go. Yeah, you don't need to. Bonjour will get you a long way, that's for sure. And merci. It's
and they can speak better English than us.
Yeah, well, generally. Yeah. So we're going to finish this set with a song dedicated to Luna Paris. This song was written by John Lewis, the piano player for the Modern Jazz Quartet. And those of you that have been in Paris, you probably know that it's a beautiful, lovely place and lovely people, I experienced. And I do actually think this song captures it up a bit quite well. And this is called Afternoon in Paris.
Thank you. Thank you.
version of this by Lee Morgan, again, I'm a little bit of a fan. And this version he recorded with Jimmy Smith on the organ. So check it out. This is called It's Wonderful. There is weird. You can look them up.
Thank you.
sing one. After all this time.
After all this time. Thank you, Dad.
That must be laughing.
I'm sorry.
Try the nostrils.
Yeah, right.
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
two. I'm sorry.
bar there, you'll notice it's always generally a good time. So this one is called Front Bar Vibes.
Thank you.
Trumpet. Personally, this is, I'm not trying to project this onto anyone at all, but for me, a jazz gig to me means that we need to play a blues, which we did, and generally a tune written by Charlie Parker. So we're going to finish this set with a song of his called Scrapple from the...
Oh, yes.
Thank you.